Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Well, how about a top 20 globular cluster that's almost right overhead for a lot of us? And isn't that hard to find because it's fairly close to one of the brightest stars in the night sky? I am talking about Messier 56, which is a rather interesting globular. I think it gets overlooked a little bit in favor of things like M22 or M13, but here are some cool facts about it. It's about 33,000 light years away. It's 84 light years across, so the light takes over a full average human lifetime to go from one side to the other. It is 13.7 billion years old, so it's nearly the age of the universe itself. Now here's what is also interesting about that. Because it's so old, and it also has a very low metals content, which means it doesn't have a lot of elements other than hydrogen and helium in it, they are some of the oldest stars out there. So when you go to look for this cluster, you'll be looking at some of the oldest stars that exist. So how do we find this cluster? Well, I'm gonna back out here and show you where we are in the sky. When we take off some of these markers, so we don't have quite so many labels floating around here, we can look and see we've got the summer triangle. So there's Vega, there's Deneb, there's Altair. We are generally looking just about overhead, somewhat eastish. I lost my cardinal point somehow. Cardinal points, by the way, you can turn on using that. And then there they are. So east to overhead, at least for where I am at 40 degrees north latitude. Vega is one of the brightest stars in the sky. It's a zero magnitude star, so kind of hard to miss, especially when it's overhead like that. Where Messier 56 is kind of halfway in between a halfway point. So if we look between Vega and Altair, about halfway we can find Alberio, which on its own is an amazing double star to definitely take a look at. But if you can see Alberio, then M56 is just about halfway in between there. I'm not sure I'm going to be able to pick it out. It's right there. It is halfway in between actually where Alberio is and this star right there, which is Sulafat. So we need to get to Sulafat at minimum just to be able to help us find this. So let's focus in on Vega. We'll go to the binoculars. And in binoculars, we can see quite a few things. There's the double-double. And if we move this direction just a little bit, we start to see the top part of where the parallelogram is. So Nasr, Al-Waqi, and along with Delta Lyrae. Delta Lyrae is actually a very cool, colorful double star to take a look at. But we want to go down into that parallelogram shape. And I'm going to bring that up really quickly with our constellation lines. And you can see there's our parallelogram. And of course, in between Shiliac and Sulafat is the Ring Nebula, which a lot of people are apt to try and find. I've covered that a couple times here with Eyes on the Sky. But we're going to go a little further than that. So we're going to use Sulafat, which is your furthest point away from Vega in Lyra. So when you have Sulafat, and this is where it's really going to help to have a magnified finder scope, because we're going to be using 5th and 6th magnitude stars to point the way to find our globular cluster. So with Sulafat there, you can move in this direction, because remember we're halfway in between there and Alberio. If you still have Shiliac and Sulafat in your field of view, you've already got Messier 56 there. So you know that it's there, and you can even see the spot that it's at. Now it's just a matter of looking at the shapes and determining how we find that. So how do we star hop there? Well, these stars, so this one and this, this one, I'm going to take off the line so we don't get too confused and think that those lines appear in the sky, because they don't. So these are largely fifth magnitude stars. This one is actually right here. That's a sixth magnitude star. But if we head back down here, we got another fifth. This one right here is a 5.6, so it's technically a 6th magnitude star. And then this one is 5.9, so a 6th magnitude star. But look at the shape that forms. And I'm going to use my measuring tool to kind of show you this. So there's this, and then there's this. It goes outside of Sulafat. So we got this nice kind of arrow shape thing with Sulafat off to the side. But these are not very far. There's only like 2 degrees or so. But if we take this line of stars, the one that's further away from Sulafat, and then just kind of continue on, that star right there, that's what we're aiming for. So we can find these other ones because they're all going to be about the same. Now, by the way, Sulafat's about a third magnitude star, so it's definitely a couple points brighter. But what you should be able to see the fifth and sixth magnitude stars through most finder scopes in most locations. So we're looking for that star right there, which is a 5.9 magnitude star, very similar to this one. I would definitely suggest that you have a large field of view or go just a little farther when you are centering things, because if you don't, and we don't do that, and we kind of zoom right in, even if you've got a 1 degree field of view, watch what happens. So there's a 1 degree field of view. M56 is just on the outside edge of that. So if you're not perfectly centered, it might look like it's actually gone a little outside of there. And then you may be like, well, but Dave, where's M56? I didn't see it. So just go just a little further than that star if you need to. If you can't see the cluster in there, go a little further. That way you'll have that cluster in the field of view with this star at the same time. And by the way, that looks like it appears to be a double star. So we got a 5.9 right there, and then the one right next to it is a 10.6. So you may be able to split those. So look for M56 that way, and then push up your magnification. Now, I've got this at 200 times. Your telescope may not support that, depending on how large your aperture is. So if you've got anything under a 4-inch or 100 millimeter aperture, don't go up to 200 times. You're going to want to limit that to about 50 times per inch of aperture or less, depending on your sky conditions. But and remember, that's really the practical maximum on that. Go less than that, especially if it looks better. If you're only at 25, 30, 40 times magnification, that's okay. But larger aperture is going to show you more stars, because this particular cluster does have some 13th magnitude stars. You won't see those probably in a 60, 70, 80 millimeter telescope, but if you have something like a 6 or 8 or 10 inch telescope, you have a good shot at resolving some of those brightest stars in this cluster. And it's one of a very, very old set of stars out there in the universe that you can see from your backyard. So check it out this week while we have the moon out of the way. M56 is a superb globular cluster to take a look at. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.